remember, a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Take that journey today. I was upset with myself a few times over the past week for feeling anxious, but I looked around, what I was doing, whom I was with, and where I was, and I realized a few years ago, I wouldn't have felt so comfortable. So I took the game, and you should too.
Anyone else suffering with a snotty nose cold? Unbelievable.
Hi. This week on WikiHole we have Muna. Top of the Hole is Leprechauns. Listen to it now, wherever you get your podcasts. Oh, it's a good one. Muna.
WikiHole.
All that work and what did it get me? Why did I do it?
Guys, you know what time it is? It's about to get hot.
I'm so excited.
You know, I get asked this question a lot, and I think that the number one, hands down, the best piece of advice or the most important characteristic in an entrepreneur is resiliency. There are so many times when things don't go as planned, things don't go your way, you know, your business or life itself just sort of punches you in the gut, and it takes somebody with enough grit and emotional muscle to really stand back up and be able to see the long-term vision in the midst of probably a really cloudy or really foggy season. You know, it's important to have a support network around you that also believes in you and believes in your vision and can help to encourage you through those seasons. You know, not that you're looking for someone to tell you how to do it, but someone that, you know, you can't have 100 people in your ear telling you you're crazy, it's never going to work out. You know, you have to have that network around you and believe in yourself and have that emotional grip, muscle, and resiliency.
Save me. And everybody wants a piece of you, baby. And all the best intentions betray me. I've got marks on my throat from the necklace you gave me back when I was your lady. And I know your girlfriend hates me, 'cause you know she can't replace me. But I've been thinking about you and me lately. Baby, come back and save me.
Is it wild for you to wrap your mind around the fact that Rather Be is quite possibly unequivocally one of the greatest pop songs of all time? And it's on the list.
Obsessed. And it's 10-year anniversary this year.
That's wild.
How cool is that? It's like mad. And I feel like I did it yesterday.
Really?
Yeah. It's incredible. It's on it's on a list of
It's on a lot of lists. Yeah.
I mean, it's a freaking amazing song and amazing moment in time, because it was, when that song came out, it was like me and Sam Smith and a few others. And it was like when collaborating was like, became a thing.
Yeah,
it was like the beginning of that era, really. And it was like I had all these moments collaborating with artists, and actually that was my fear. It was like I'm a solo artist and I was collaborating and I had all these amazing records, and then I was like, oh my god, like what am I gonna do when I want to release my own one? Like, oh my gosh, I have to do one on my own ASAP in case, like. And I don't know why I ever feared it, because you know, it's all about the belief system and a great song or whatever. And like, I really, you know, but yeah, it's mad.
We tested our brains on.
It's my birthday, but you're making me work.
Yes. Is that what I'm doing?
Yes.
I'm making her work on her birthday.
Yeah.
then. Ooh.
What happened to him?
It died.